Hello everybody, welcome to this instruction video. In this video I'd like to show you the third part for the make-along connected cushion designed by Martin from Martin Up North. In this third video I'll be showing you how to make the double border that's around the fabric that we made in parts 1 and 2. It'll involve working a row of slip stitches and then working a double border on the front and the back of the fabric. And then that works away all the yarn tails, so they're all nicely hidden below here. I'm still using Scheepjes stonewashed yarn, and this time I'm using a different color because I'm going to use the color that I've made my border with. And you'll be using two hook sizes because you need a larger hook for the slip stitches that you're going to be making. So I'll show you how to work all of these slip stitches. I'll show you it all the way around and then show you the three rows of the border on the front and the back and how to make the pocket. So thank you for watching, and I hope it was a useful video for you. And before we start with the actual border, what we're first going to do is we're actually going to get a grip on all these yarn tails. What we're going to do is we're going to tie them together two by two. So now it doesn't, I'm just going to go like this because that's just slightly easier for me. Yeah. So what I'm going to do is any two yarn tails that are next to each other, let me just zoom in a little bit. So any two yarn tails, so the first two, take these two and double knot them together. And two. Then comes to the next two and double knot those together. And this literally is just two knots, nothing simple, nothing complicated, just two knots. Now go like this all the way around. So tie all your yarn tails together, and this is a very satisfying job because at the end of this we're going to be cutting them off. So go around, tie all your yarn tails together two by two, and let me see which is the next two. Yes, these are the next two. Tie them all together, and then I'll see you back for the next step. So at first, go and tie all your yarn tails two by two. When you've tied all your knots, this takes a few moments, you're now going to cut off your yarn tails at roughly 3 centimeters an inch, you know, roughly something like that. And you just literally cut them all off until they're and like this, and then you go all the way around. And then you have them. Have these short little stubby yarn tails, and then we're going to work a border and then we'll cover those, so don't worry about them. So you can cut them all off, go all the way around, cut them to roughly when they're a centimeter or 3 centimeters or so to an inch. Next step after you've cut all your yarn tails is we're going to work a row of slip stitches along the edge of the panel, so all the way around, and we're going to be doing that in every row. So you're going to work 69 slip stitches. And if I just rotate my work, where we're going to be doing that, and I'll show you this every stitch, but where we're going to be working is, if you look here at the edge here, this is where we're going to be working. So in the stitches that are exactly here on this edge, that's where we're going to be working slip stitches. And for these, for this border, I'm going to be using a different color, and it's important to go up a hook size for the slip stitches. So for the slip stitches, I'm going to use a hook size larger, and I'm going to be doing that in my border color. So where we're going to start, this is the start point of the panel. So these were this was rows 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So these first rows, and here, these are the increasing stitches that we were making. So we're going to start on any one of these increasing rows. It doesn't matter where you start because we're going to be working all the way around anyway. So here are these two single crochets worked in one stitch, and I'm going to start in there. And I'm just going to rotate my work a bit because that's easier. And this here is my border color. I'm going to use a pink for the border. Now insert your hook in any of these increase rows, and we can insert our hook here, there, there, and there, and there, and there. I'm going to line up these slip stitches. So I'm just going to insert my hook here. It doesn't matter exactly where you take, but there. So this is where you've worked one of those double crochets into. So I'm going to insert my hook in there, and then just grab my yarn from the back. I realize the pattern starts here with a slip knot. I prefer to just pick up a slip stitch, but you could also make a slip knot on your hook here. Then go to the next row, and you see there's this single crochet stitch. I'm just going to insert my hook in there. I realize this can be maybe a bit hard to see because I've also got it at an angle, because otherwise I can't hold the fabric. And pick up your yarn from the back and work a slip stitch. And now you're again going to be working in a stitch here where you've got a double crochet in. Insert your hook, pick up the loop, and work a slip stitch. Again, the next stitch here, this stitch here has a single crochet in it. See there? I'm going to insert my hook, pick up the loop from the back, and work the slip stitch. And I'm actually... what can happen is that's also what's happening now, is that these yarn tails, that they get stuck in your slip knots and your slip stitches. You don't want that because it's going to make it look ugly. So make sure that you're really not pulling these yarn tails to the front, that you don't do that. So just keeping it tidy. You see now I've already got three slip stitches here, and this first one is rather big, so don't worry about that. That's just because it's the first stitch, but as such, this stitch, the rest is a bit shorter. And then I'm going to one stitch at a time, keeping track of not pulling through the yarn, not pulling the yarn tails to the front, work a slip stitch along the edge. And this is time consuming, so don't rush this. And you want to make sure that your slip stitches are all, well, roughly the same size, but to give them some room. So don't pull these slip stitches too tight. They can make them a little, perhaps just a little larger than you normally would, because that's going to make sure that your fabric doesn't pull in on itself. So really give this little room to breathe. You see here I've got again a row with a single crochet stitch worked in it. And here's a stitch, it's a double crochet work. You see, and there I'm pulling as you see here, I'm pulling one of the yarn tails from the back and pulling it to the front again. I don't want that. And this is, yeah, there are just so many yarn tails in the way, so you really need to be sure that you don't pull them to the front. So I've now worked a few of these already. I'm going to continue this, I'm going to make a jump in the video until I'm to the corner, and then I'd just like to show you the corner and go around the corner. For now, continue working these slip stitches, and don't worry if they're not exactly straight. You can see they're reasonably straight, but when we do the next border rows, you won't even notice this. So I'm almost here to the first corner, and this is actually the decrease. So here we started working single crochets to togethers, so to decrease the stitches. So here we go from increase to decrease, so that's the corner where I'm at right now. I just have a few more slip stitches to do, and what I'm going to do, if I just pull up my hook, is I'm going to work until this stitch here, and then I'm going to go around the corner. So I'm just going to work a few more. So you see here I'm in a stitch that has this double crochet, then I go into that stitch that has the single, and then I go to this stitch here. This is another single crochet stitch that has a single in it. There. And now I'm going to turn my work. So now I'm going to work along this edge here. And like I said, this is maybe a little bit just eyeballing your work and thinking where is the best place to turn, because it's not per se cast in stone like where you place that turning slip stitch, but this is the choice that I made. So, and now I'm going to work along the edge up again. So I'm going to go to this stitch here, I work the slip stitch. And what might actually be really useful is to mark this turning stitch, this first stitch that's on your next edge. The reason is then it's going to be easier. So this was the first slip stitch I just made on the second edge. I'm just going to mark that stitch. The reason is when we're going to be doing the border, you need to know which stitch is on this edge and which stitch is on that edge. And this is the first stitch of the next edge. So that's why I've marked this stitch. This is just to help me on the next row, that I'm not in doubt, exactly where is the corner, because these slip stitches, they look a bit round on the corner as opposed to, a hard edge. So that's why. And here your stitches look slightly different because you have the single crochets two togethers. I'm sorry, this just very large and clumsy piece of fabric that I have here, and my yarn is getting all twisted. So now I'm going to look at a slightly different place to work these stitches. And this really is a case of just estimating where am I going to place those slip stitches. I'm going to go for that stitch there. And then the single crochet here. And then the single crochet up. This single crochet here. You can see how that makes that edge look nice. And I'll be honest, I'm not exactly sure if this is the stitches that the designer intended, but these are the stitches that work for me. So again, work all of these slip stitches until you're to the next corner. And then I'll just show you that corner again as well. I'm going to show you each and every corner. So again, I'm going to work all of these slip stitches, and I'm working them here in this single crochet, and there, and there, and there, and there, and there. So every row and you're going to have 69 of these when you get to the end. So just again, continue, and I'll see you at the next corner. So this is the point where I'm at now. This is the next corner, and this is actually the end of the fabric. So these were all single crochets together. So these were all a decrease, and this is the last rows, row 130 something. So I'm just working these last slip stitches, and I've got one more here that I want to work in this row. So I'm going to work it there, and I now have 60 slip stitches. Count these slip stitches, starting at the marked stitch, another reason to have marked it. So this is your first stitch, so count these, because you want to have 69 at the end. And if you have, if you're at this point and you've got a different number, then you've most likely skipped a row somewhere. So you should have 60 by now, because you have 9 rows left here. And again, a slip stitch on every row. That's what we're going to be doing. And this is again a little bit eyeballing where you're going to put those stitches, because you've got rows of single crochets. I mean, you want a slip stitch on every row, and try to keep the line going that you've already made with these slip stitches. So you've got these stitches here, so try to keep this line intact, that you don't go to the left. So try to keep this line going. And you're going to work a slip stitch on every row. 1, and like I said, and this is now really a little bit of eyeballing where you're going to place those stitches. And there's one on every row. And I'm actually not completely happy with this line, but yeah, it is what it is. One on every row, and then this should be the last stitch. Let me just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. No, I need another one. I'm going to place it here. I'm going to push my hook in there, and this should be 60 9 slip stitches. Now I'm just going to count them again to double check that I have 69. So I've just taken a moment to count them again, and I do have exactly 69 slip stitches. So now we're going to rotate the corner again, and that means now we're going to come up. So you see this fabric is really a little clumsy, and maybe I'm just not being very efficient today. And now we're going to do exactly the same as we've done before. We're going to come up, work a slip stitch on every single crochet row, and then here again along the edge work those slip stitches. And again, just eyeball your work a little bit on where you place those slip stitches. I'm again going to mark the first stitch of the row. So I'm going to place my first slip stitch there. And this is the first one of the next row. And I'm just going to mark that again to help me count, but also when we start making the actual border working into these slip stitches. So that's one. And two. So one on every row. Three. And there are here and there, there's some of these natural holes. They're just a little bit bigger. I'm actually using those holes. And this one here. And now I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then this one here is, and actually number 8 I'm going to make, see that little, I'm sorry, let me just come down a bit. See that single crochet stitch there? That one there, I'm just going to work in there. Because your work is now, relatively speaking, is upside down to, you know, the previous row. So it looks a little different, but the idea is the same. So every row, so here I've got a double crochet, that single there. I'm just going to insert my hook in there, make a slip stitch, and then come to the next row. There. Again, make these slip stitches large enough, that single there, that you don't pull your work. So it might even feel that you're making them maybe even too big, but that's okay. That's good. Because you don't want your work to pull. And again, work a slip stitch along the fabric on every row until you're to the other side. And then I'll show you the next corner again. I'm going to show you all the way around. So now I've worked a few of these. Keep sure that your yarn tails, you don't work them into your work. So continue to work these slip stitches, and I'll see you at the next corner. So almost to the next corner again. Here are my slip stitches, and I need to make two more. So again, count all your slip stitches. I have 67 right now. So I'm going to work one here. This is number 68. And then here for the turn, I'm just going to eyeball it. And I'm going to make it there. This is the last one that I'm going to make. This is number 69. And like I said, that is just really eyeballing it, just where I think it should go. And then again, turn your work by a quarter. Actually, rotate your work is a better term. And then we're going to work the next edge. And again, I have a stitch marker because I'm going to mark the first stitch. And now again, going to work. And here we have this was an increase row. So here we have two single crochets along the edge. And this first one, I'm just going to take that single crochet, the bottom of that single crochet there. I'm going to work the first one. So this is one. Again, I'm just going to mark this stitch because you can really see how it looks more like a curve than a corner. So I'm just going to mark that first stitch to help me later on. And now the same idea, slip stitch on every row. And this one here is going to be at the bottom of the double crochet. And then the next one here is going to be in this single here. No, I'm not happy with that. I'm going to take it here. Yes, that's single. That one's better. And then the double again. At the bottom of the double, I should say. And then here, this single crochet. See how I've worked those? And repeat until you're to the end of the row. And then we're going to have the first few rows, actually, of the fabric. So rows 1 to 7 to enter 9, so that order of magnitude. Work all of these slip stitches. Give these slip stitches enough room to breathe. Continue along, working one on every row, and I'll see you for the last corner. Again, I'm almost towards the end of the pattern rows, and here are these single crochet rows. And I'm just going to work one more slip stitch in there, here. And now again, it's a case of keeping track of this line and working to the corner. And this is a little bit of just looking at your work and thinking, okay, where am I going to place that slip stitch? Just keep one in every row. As you see here, these are two rows, and these are two rows, so that way you can keep track of your stitches. And this is a little bit of an educated guess in that sense. And I do believe that I need one more, but I'm not sure. I'm going to work this slip stitch. I'm just going to count how many I have now, if this is 69 or perhaps 70, so I'm just going to count my slip stitches. Counted my slip stitches again, and I have exactly 69. So perfect. So I'm going to rotate my work again and work slip stitches until the beginning. And this is the point where I began. So I'm just going to work slip stitches again, and I'm again just going to mark the first stitch. And again, this is just eyeballing where you place that first slip stitch, and I just mark this first one. If you want to, you can actually also mark it on the back, but I'll do that at the end. And then work slip stitches until you get to the point where you started. Now, depending on where exactly on the edge you started, this will be more or less stitches. So I'm going to work a slip stitch on every row. My hook is stuck. What have I done? Until you get to the point where we started the row with the slip stitches. And then again, double check that you have 69 slip stitches. So I'm going to work these slip stitches until I get here. Now I'm almost all the way around. I have one more stitch to do, and that's this last slip stitch. And the pattern says indeed gonna work this last slip stitch and then close on this first stitch with a slip stitch. So like this. But what I'm actually going to do is I'm gonna do this very slightly different. I'm just gonna I've got one stitch left, and now I'm just gonna do this with an invisible join. So as such, the pattern calls to close on the first stitch with a slip stitch. But I'm just going to cut my yarn, open up this loop, and then do an invisible join here. Because I find that's more pretty, for no other reason than that. So I'm just going to come to the last stitch, under both loops, and then come to the last stitch worked. And pull your yarn to the back. And then that's the last slip stitch. Now they all look the same, and that's just the reason why. And what I'm going to do here to the back, very practical. So I'm just going to tie these two yarn tails together, so from the beginning and the end. And then that's also going to create a slip stitch on the back, because we're going to need this slip stitch on the back. You see that creates one here to the back as well. And there we go. And I'm just going to double tie this knot, so it's nice and secure. And again, just cut off the yarn tails, because they're going to be to the back anyways. And now, maybe it's a little too late, but as such, you should again have 69 slip stitches on this edge as well. So at this point, you have 69 slip stitches on every edge, and you've marked the corner stitch of each, or actually the first stitch of each edge. We're now going to work double crochets on either edge of the fabric. What I'm just first going to do is, we've marked the first stitch on the front, so I'm just going to mark the same stitch on the back. And if you're in doubt which stitch it is, so this one is the one to the front, if you're in doubt, just poke your hook through the stitch, for example here. Then now, okay, this is the end of the stitch, just poke your hook through. And you can see from the back, oh, okay, that's the end, so it's that loop there. So if you're in doubt, just poke your hook through to double check which stitch it exactly is. So you're going to mark the same stitch on the front and the back of your fabric. And I'm going to do that on all four corners. So this is the next corner. So again here, if I'm in doubt, I'm just going to poke my hook through, and then I see, okay, it's that loop there, that one there. So I'm just going to mark that loop, and I'm going to do the same with the other two corners as well. So now you've got, you can see that they're both marked on either side of the fabric. So we're going to do the same on the other two corners also, so for the last two stitch markers, and then we're ready to start with the double crochets. For round one of the border, so we're going to have the back of our work facing the back, and we're going to be working in these slip stitches that you see here on the back. We're going to be working into those, and the pattern calls for a double crochet in every stitch. Now it doesn't exactly state how to start, so I'm just going to take the liberty of starting with a standing stitch. Now, like I said, that's pure liberty that I'm taking here. Got a slip knot on my hook, yarn over, and then it doesn't matter where you start. So I'm just going to pick this loop here, and then go underneath that loop. So this is the back loops of the slip stitches, and work a double crochet. And now we're going to work a double crochet on every stitch, until there's one stitch left, and that's why we've marked this stitch, because this marked stitch is the start of the new edge. So that's important. This is the start of the new edge, and then we're going to work until the stitch before that. And that's why it's just good to have these stitches marked, because then you can really see where your corner is. So work a double crochet on every stitch until you've got one stitch left, and that's of course what I'm doing here. And I of course purposefully started reasonably close to the border, or to the corner, because then I can easily show you the going around the corner. And sometimes you may just have to help that loop a little bit to get it on your hook, because you're going to want to go, there we go, underneath that loop. Alright. And actually, because we're working from the back, on the back side, this corner, this loop actually marks the last stitch of the edge. So on the back side of your work, this loop is the last stitch, and on the front side, this loop is the first stitch. So do keep that in mind. So we're going to work until we get to that marked stitch. So that means in the next stitch, work one double crochet, And now we're to the marked stitch on the back. So you've got the back of your work facing. And on that stitch, you're going to work two double crochets. Now I'm just going to remove the stitch marker because I know it's the next stitch, it's the one that we're talking about. Two double crochets in that stitch. That's one and two. So two double crochets in the one stitch. Chain three. One, two, three. And if your gauge is a little tighter, you might actually want, or a bit looser, you might actually want to do a chain two here. I'm personally going to do a chain two, but the pattern calls for a chain three. I've noticed that my gauge is different to the designer's gauge. And then in the next stitch, so this is the corner, then in the next stitch, work two double crochets again. So this is going to be the first stitch of the next edge. And again, there we go. These stitches can be a little tight. Oh, sorry, two. You need to work two in the first stitch. I wasn't paying attention. So two double crochets in the first stitch. And now you can see how you've made a corner here. So two, chain space, two. So this is a corner, a very clear corner. And now it's one double crochet on every stitch until you get, well, to the next corner, and that's the next marked stitch. So you're going to work double crochet on every stitch, and that's going to be 68, because remember you had 69 of these slip stitches. So you're going to work 68 double crochets, and let me just find my stitch marker. So what you're going to do is work a double crochet on all of these slip stitches, so all of those. So you see these little loops here, on all of them until you get to the marked stitch. And in the marked stitch, which is exactly the same as the one we just had, you work two doubles because this is the last stitch of the edge. So it's two doubles, then the chain space, and two doubles in the next stitch also. So then this here is your corner. So exactly the same as we've done here. So the first marked stitch is the start of the corner. So the two doubles, the chain space, and the two doubles on the next stitch. And this you're going to repeat all the way round until you get back to the first stitch, and then close here on the standing stitch. You see where I've got my hook inserted, and close there with a slip stitch that we can do the next round also. Now, when you've gone all the way around, this is what your work looks like. And this is still the wrong side facing. And now in the second row, again, you're going to work a double crochet on every stitch. And in the corner, it's two doubles, chain three, and two doubles. So that's the idea for row two. So I'm just going to do a chain. Now, this chain three here, this counts as your first double crochet. So that's in the first one. And then come to your next stitch. And work a double, and work a double in every stitch till you're to the corner. So this is this is the first half of the border, because it's a double border, because we're going to work this from two sides, and then we're going to nicely package all these yarn tails that are kind of in the hanging there. They're going to be nicely packaged between the two layers of the border. So work a double crochet on every stitch until you're to the chain space, and the last one. Then in the chain space, two doubles, chain three, or like I'm going to do chain two or chain three, two doubles, chain three as the pattern calls for, and two doubles. And then again, a double crochet on every stitch to the next corner. And you're going to repeat that all the way round. So this is a nice and relaxed round, just double crochets on every stitch. And when you get to a corner, two doubles, chain space, chain three, and two doubles. When you get back to the beginning, close on the chain three, close on that stitch with a slip stitch, and then you can also fasten off. We're now going to do the second half of the border. Now you're going to have the right side, so this is the right side of your work facing. And we're again going to start in any slip stitch and work actually again two rows of double crochets, just like we did to the back. We're going to do exactly the same, this time from the front. Now you can attach your yarn with a slip stitch in any stitch, so like this, attach with any stitch your yarn, chain three, and then start the doubles. I'm just going to actually start with a standing stitch, and this is just something I prefer because then I like the look of the standing stitches more than I do of the chain start. So I'm just going to start in any position, and I'm again going to start reasonably close to the corner because then I can quickly show you the corner. So in any slip stitch, go through both loops. At the back there was only one loop, but at the front you've got two, so go through both loops and work, in this case, a standing double crochet. And again, work a double crochet on every stitch till you get to the corner. And now I've marked the, and that again, why I've marked these stitches, because then I can really see where the corner is, so I don't get any unpleasant surprises like, oh, I've missed the corner. So a double crochet on every stitch. There we go. And here's the marked stitch. And remember, on the front of our work, this marked stitch was the start of the next row. On the back, it was the other way around. So this means the stitch before the corner gets two double crochets. So the stitch before the corner, two double crochets. And sometimes these stitches are a little tight because you already worked into them from the back also, because they are, so they might be a little tight. So I've got two double crochets in the stitch before the chain, before the chain space, or sorry, before the marked stitch. I'm now going to make chain space. I'm going to do a chain two here. The pattern calls for a chain three. This is gauge, so I'm going to do a chain two, but do a chain three if you want to stay more true to the pattern. Then in the next stitch, which is again a marked stitch, I'm going to work two double crochets. And then that's your corner very clearly made. One. Two. Just rotate my work. I'm just actually folding this edge here to the back, so it's not not in the way. And now again, a double crochet on every stitch till you're to the next corner. So if you look at the next corner, you're going to do exactly the same. Work a double crochet until you get here. On that stitch before the marked stitch gets two doubles, then a chain space and two doubles on the marked stitch, and then that's your second corner. So you're going to go like this all the way around and then close on your first stitch with a slip stitch. And like I said, these stitches are now a little tighter because you've already got double crochets into the back, because you've already got double crochets there in the back, so that's why these slip stitches are now just a little tighter. We'll go through, or actually I should say underneath the slip stitches, work a double crochet on every stitch, and when you get to the corner, which I just explained, two doubles, chain space, two doubles, go all the way around, and when you're back here, close on that first stitch, either the chain three starting or the standing stitch, close with a slip stitch, and then we're ready for round two of the border. Round two of the border, I'm still on the front side border, We're going to work a double crochet on every stitch, and in the corner, two doubles, chain three, and two doubles. That's what we're going to be doing. I'm going to start with a chain three, it's the first stitch, and then work a double crochet on every stitch. And this row is of course the same as the previous second row, so the one that we worked here to the back is the same as that second row. So a double crochet on every stitch. When you get to the chain corner space, two doubles, two, chain two, or chain three if you want to stay closer to the pattern, and two doubles, and then continue on the next edge, work a double crochet on every stitch. Continue like this all the way around, so in every corner two doubles, chain space, two doubles, then a double on every stitch. You get it to the beginning, close on the chain three with a slip stitch, and leave your yarn attached, very important, because we're going to be joining these rows together in the next row. So leave your yarn attached at the end of row two. Round three of the border, we're still the right side facing. We're now actually going to tie the front and back rows of double crochets. We're going to work them together, and in the process we're going to fold in all these yarn tails, and they're all going to be inside, so you're not going to see any of them. We're going to do that with a round of single crochets. Now chain one, this does not count as a stitch. Then in the stitch where you're currently in, so insert your hook through all of the loops and come to the same stitch on the other side. And I've actually marked this stitch here because I've got 8 stitches before the corner, and I also just took 8 stitches back. So I've just marked that stitch there, and that's just to help me find the correct position. So insert your hook through all of them, bring your loop forward, and work a single crochet. And we're going to do this until we get to the corner. So that means in the next stitch, now we insert through both loops of the next stitch and this stitch behind, and work a single crochet. Oh. And again, and you're going to repeat this until you get to the corner, and then you're going to work two single crochets, chain two, and two single crochets in the corner. See how as you're joining this, how you're making a pocket, and you're closing that pocket, and that's going to cover all of these yarn tails that you have here. And I'll just get to the corner, and then I'd like to show you the corner. And because I counted back, it works out exactly. So this is my last stitch here, and that's my last stitch there. Then in the chain space, now you go through both chains on both sides. So one, two single crochets, chain two according to the pattern, and then one, two single crochets to make the corner. And then you continue on the next edge in the same way. So you're going to say here, it's going to fold in all these yarn tails, and you're not going to have to work away anything except for the very last yarn tail. The first stitch on this side and the first stitch on the other side, and then through all the loops, work a single crochet, and then this is the last row. You can see how this nicely fashions and ties your double border. So continue like this, work a single crochet through every stitch all the way around, and then in the corners two singles, chain space and two singles. When you go all the way around, this is what your work looks like. You've got the nice double border at the edge and then your fabric is finished. You can sew this onto a cushion cover and then you have your project finished. So this brings us to the end of the official part of this make along. I have another video in which I show you a few variations that I've made on the pattern. Thank you for watching. Hope to see you again for a new project.